again, this is Kent from simpletutorials.net. Hope you're having a great day. Today we're going to be doing a video on the Bezier tool. So the title of this is Inkscape Bezier Tutorial. To do that, we'll click on our Bezier tool. Now there's a few actions you want to use with this. First, we're going to be doing just a simple straight line path segments. And to do that, use your mouse, your left button on your mouse, and you click and then move your mouse, click again, click again, click again, click again. Now once we get to the end of our path that we are drawing, you can stop this or complete this path by either double clicking like that. And better yet, a better way to do that, to stop that path, would be to hit enter, your enter key on your keyboard. Another way to stop it is to actually close your path by going back to the first node. Then we want to start drawing just straight segments, but making curves. So the way you want to do that is you can simply click your left mouse button to start, and then once you get to another place in your drawing space, you click and you hold it down, and then while you're holding your left button down, you drag your mouse, move your mouse to some other place on your mouse pad, and then let go. And then you can go to your next place, click, drag, and or move your mouse to whatever you want. So I'm going up with my mouse and down with my mouse. You just keep on doing that, and then hit my enter key to stop that path. Additionally, when you draw your segments, you can hold your control key down, and when you hold your control key down, it restricts it to 15 degree angles, or so that's 15 degrees, 30 degrees, 45, etc. So that might be helpful to know. You can always look at the angles down here at the bottom to see where we are. Right now we're at 0 and then at 15 degrees. Okay, anyway. It's also interesting to note that you can draw another path that will connect to this particular path that's actually enabled. You hold your shift key down and start your path, click, click, and then click on the node that you want to connect to, and that creates one path between those two. Another interesting trick that I picked up well beyond the first time I knew how to use Inkscape is that when you're drawing a path like this, and then you end it by hitting enter key, instead of, let's say I wanted to select this and move it some other place, instead of going all the way up here for your selector tool, you can actually hit your spacebar key. Now this works similar for, I think, every tool. So right now I'm in selector mode and I'm moving the path around. Also interesting to note is if you hit your spacebar again right after using your selector tool, it'll move right back to the tool that you were using before that. And in this case, it's the Bezier tool. It also might be handy to know that when you're drawing your path, maybe you accidentally made a node that you didn't mean to, or you want to change it. All you need to do is hit backspace like that, or delete key on your keyboard. So you can go all the way back to the point of getting rid of your whole path. Also, while we're doing this, using this Bezier tool and creating paths, it's interesting to note that to get into edit mode, all you have to do is double click on your path like this. So then you can edit your nodes or your handles of your nodes like that. Okay. Also, while we have these paths here, you can always, once you're in the selector mode, You can always change them like this, scaling them. You can hold your control key down to keep the same aspect ratio. You can also click it again and rotate them. After you create your paths, you might want to put a fill in there. So what you can do, you can easily just go down to one of these colors and click on it with your left button on your mouse like this. And you can do the same thing for those paths that are closed. You can hold your shift key down as you select one of these colors, and it will change your stroke, the line that you drew the path with. So you see that? How it changed. And then also you can go down here and change the width of the stroke pretty easily. You can also right-click, and I'm right-clicking over this number, sorry I didn't say that, to change the width. There's also other selections you can put in there, and you can also right-click in these areas, this fill area, you can remove the fill. You can put a fill in there, black or whatever, and then you can do the same thing, right-click on the stroke area and change the stroke. Or you can actually click with your left button in one of these areas, and it'll go into the fill and stroke window, and you can manipulate the stroke and fill that way. Okay, so stay tuned or go to the part two and you'll see me working with the mode and the shape. This is Kent from simpletutorials.net. If you like this video, please like it, and if you want to see more, please subscribe. Thank you very much.